Welcome to New Directions for Women, a program of the Morris County, New Jersey chapter of the National Organization for Women. My name is Rebecca Lubetkin, and I and the entire production crew here are members of this chapter of NOW. We do have a student assistant, and hopefully he'll become a member of the Morris County chapter of NOW at some point. We're all volunteers. Not only the people here in the studio, the floor manager, the camera people, but also all the people in the control room, from producer to director to audio and graphics. And we have a good show for you today called Boomers and Beyond, Challenges of the New Retirement. And we're going to explore issues for women as they age and as those they care for age. We are so fortunate to have a guest whose knowledge and personal experience offer us extraordinary insights. Fay Radding is a senior gerontologist at the MetLife Mature Market Institute in Westport, Connecticut. Fay is on the cutting edge providing training and education as well as consultation on the Institute's studies and polls within the broader context of today's changing societal trends. She's also the co-editor, and hopefully you're going to tell us about this, of Quick Facts, the Institute's monthly electronic newsletter, and other Institute consumer publications. Welcome, Fay.
Thank you so much.
I'm so glad you could be with us. This is a topic of great interest to us as boomers and as children of boomers, and what I'm interested in is how you became interested in issues of aging, of seniors, and especially of women as they age.
Oh, well.
So if you tell us a little bit about yourself and your background.
Sure, delighted. Later in life, I actually became a nurse and worked with individuals as well as their families. And over time, my career basically became more focused on families who were caring for their aging loved ones. So I focused on the issues of family caregiving. And as I helped family caregivers, I also became aware of the MetLife's Mature Market Institute. And they also had a special focus on issues of family caregiving. And that's more or less how I became a full-time gerontologist at the MetLife Mature Market Institute.
Well, what is a gerontologist?
A gerontologist, we are experts in the issues of aging and retirement, and we study them. We go to bed at night thinking about what's in the hearts and minds of people as they transition to the second half of life.
So is it, would it be a background in nursing, social work?
Any of those, probably.
Demographics?
Demographics, we study all of those things at the MetLife Mature Market Institute. In fact, MetLife became aware of the changing trends and demographics and realized over 10 years ago that it was important for individuals to be educated on the issues of aging and retirement and what the risks are and opportunities are for people as they transition to older age. And so that's how the Mature Market Institute came into being.
And so you do have a website then, the Mature Market Institute?
That's right, maturemarketinstitute.com.
.com, and I hope we'll, oh it is, we have it up now. So when we talk about mature market, what age group are we talking about?
Well, it's interesting. You know, boomers are becoming mature, and we look at boomers, we look at the older population, but also as the issues of aging are really a family issue. All generations are really involved as their families age, their parents, their grandparents. So at this point, Mature Market Institute looks at all the different generations. In fact, we have a slide. We can show all the different generations. It's an age, it's almost like an age wave where we see the earlier generations being a smaller population. And as the boomers came onto the scene, we see a big crest in the wave. And following the boomers, there was a drop-off in population. That's Generation X. And then almost a baby boom from, there's the slide, and we're looking at Gen Y, is primarily children of boomers, and it's another baby boom. It's sometimes called a boomerang generation.
And that's Generation Y?
Generation Y, right. And in fact, the Mature Market Institute recently published a number of demographic profiles that I brought with me to show you. And we have here, I brought three out of the six of them. We see that
it says America's older boomers, middle boomers, and younger boomers.
That's right, that's right. So we broke down the boomers into three different cohorts. And we also have these wonderful demographic profiles to show for the 65-plus population, Generation X, and Generation Y. And what's interesting about these is that they show a timeline, all kinds of interesting data, and a timeline, a historical timeline, of the different events that really impacted people.
Can we get those?
Absolutely. They're all available on our website. People can send us an email or send us a letter, or there's a phone number where people can call in. All available for free.
Oh, nice.
MatureMarketInstitute.com.
Very nice. So what is a boomer?
A boomer is an individual who was born between 1964 and 1946. And it's a population of about
46 to 64.
60, yes. Okay. Uh-huh. Right. And a population of 77 million or more people.
So how old would that make them now? They're around 65? Or?
Boomers will turn 65 next year. So they're 45 to 64.
And this is the largest generation that we've ever had, is that?
Well, at the time that they were born, they numbered one out of three. And now what we see is with all the other younger people coming up and with the boomerang children coming, boomers number about 26% of our total population. Mm. They have actually captured the fascination and interest of the marketing professionals and dominated the media for the last six decades.
Because they're so large.
So large, exactly.
So what'll happen now is they're going to be eligible for Social Security in 2 years.
Medicare, right? Medicare next year.
Medicare at 65.
Right.
Social and Security at 66 and something, or
67?
Well,
the oldest boomers were eligible to start taking Social Security, of course, at age 62. Mm-hmm. So some of them started taking Social Security in 2008.
So what is that going to do to our budget problems with regard to Medicare and Social Security?
Well, it's a big population, that's for sure. And with the longevity being what it is, and people living longer, you know, we all have to prepare financially for a long life ahead of us. It wasn't always like this for previous generations.
When Social Security was started, how long were people living? How long would people be expected to live on Social Security?
Well, Social Security was created in 1965. So if we look to the earlier part of this of that century, earlier in 1900, life expectancies were around 48, 45. Mm-hmm. And in 2000, life expectancies at birth for a man and for a woman are more in the 70s. But when a person becomes 65, we have a different actuarial information that tells us that at 65, a woman has a 50-50 chance of living beyond age 88.
Oh, wow.
And a man a few years younger. And a couple who are both 65 married, one of the two has a 50% chance of living beyond age 92 and a 25% of chance of living beyond age 97. And it will probably be the woman.
So
marriage is good for longevity.
It sounds that way.
That's it.
But it sounds also as though the years of being so-called retired might be longer than the years of working.
Exactly. Retirement could be 20, 30, or even 40 years. So it's a very different...
With no income from productive life, and the income would be from other things.
Well, that's what people need to think about now, what they will do in retirement. As retirement could be 20, 30, or even 40 years, how will you spend your time in retirement? How will you not outlive your savings? And what really matters in retirement?
And how is that an issue that would be of concern, particularly to women?
Well, women actually live on average 7 years longer than men. So, and women are also likely to earn less than men. They're also likely to more likely to be a caregiver, and they're more likely to end up living alone. So they particularly need to think about how they will plan to spend and afford life in retirement.
And living alone means housing issues, then.
Housing issues, certainly a major piece of it. I'd just like to mention that this whole phase of life, the Mature Market Institute was very curious about what really matters to people as they age.
Yes.
So we partnered with a life coach, Richard Leiter. He's the author of over 7 books. I think his 8th book is just coming out soon, on the issues of, he's a life coach, as I said, and he was mentioned by Forbes as one of the top 5 life coaches. And we partnered with Richard to determine what really matters as people age. So what we found was that purpose is really the glue that holds the good life together. And Richard's theory is that there are 3 basic components: money, we all need money, medicine, which is a metaphor for health, and meaning, or purpose. And that the good life is basically a balance between these 3 components: money, medicine, and meaning. And he defined the good life as living in the place where you belong, with the people you love, doing the right work on purpose. And work could be defined in many different ways, whether that be caring for your family is your purpose, your work.
That doesn't bring in money.
It doesn't bring in money. But so we looked at Richard's formula, and we asked people as they age what really brings them satisfaction, how do they define the good life, and purpose was the glue that held the good life together. So we found that people who have purpose are more likely to be happy. And in partnership with Richard, we put together a workbook that basically can guide people through the various steps of discovering what they need to think about when planning for retirement. So you asked about what women need to think about in retirement. Certainly, as women will live a long life, they will need to plan financially, and think about where they want to live. We can talk about housing options, and what they will do, how they will spend their time, how they will find purpose and meaning and a reason to get up every morning. And this wonderful guide is available also free for people on our website.
And what is it called?
It's called Discovering What Matters, Your Guide to the Good Life. And it comes with a DVD, again, available to the public.
And you said something before that intrigued me. You said that married women live longer? Married
couples have a greater probability of living longer. So it is an interesting point. Why would that be? Why would married people have greater chances of longevity? Well, what many of the studies point to is that people contact, social contact, your friends, your family, your loved one, give you, you know, happiness, purpose and meaning, mental stimulation.
So engaging with people is one of the components of
the good life.
Of the good life.
Absolutely.
Or of purpose.
Of purpose. And we ask people what gives them purpose, and the top main thing that all people cited at all age groups, we looked at people from 45 to 70, is spending time with friends and family is what is the top most cited item for purpose and meaning.
Sometimes I wonder whether people are just saying that because it's a good answer. You know, because when I look at how much time some young people spend with families, it doesn't seem as though that's
their purpose. Well, at younger ages, they're certainly very concerned about making money. Mm-hmm. And as people age, they're more concerned with their health and, again, also friends and family.
That's interesting. And you said that women will more likely be alone.
That's right. We see more women in the nursing homes, and we just know that women